Hello everyone, this is Exotica New York show on the air. This program is brought to you by Manhattan Neighborhood Network Channel 34. Tonight, David Glenn artwork. David Glenn work, it's about our bodies and our feelings toward being in time, consciousness, and sexual duality. I hope you enjoy the show. I am Eny Hanson.
Hi, my name is David Glenn. I'm a painter. We're in my studio. This is one of the paintings I'm working on. This is a grisaille and underpainting in black and white for finished painting, which will be full color oils on linen. It's part of my Nudes and Numbers series. I use numbers the way letters were used in illuminated manuscripts in medieval texts, where the first letter of a word would be used as sort of a compositional architecture. And then the decorations we put around that. And I have done a lot of work with computer art as well. I have a website, www.glynns.com, which is G-L-Y-N-N-S. And I have an interactive CD-ROM where I combine my paintings and photographs of the models that I work with video and underwater video that I've done of model swimming, all together on an interactive CD-ROM, which is available through my website or my phone number, which is 888-OWN-WORK or 696-9675. The idea of painting with the computer took me over after I got out of art school. And in 1984, when the Macintosh first came out, I found out you could paint without needing to know how to program at all. I got seriously into that, and then the painting programs got so good that they could replicate paintings exactly down to the textures and everything, that I started working again with the actual paintings and incorporating my drawings and paintings and photographs into the computer compositions that I had scanned, and then making prints, some of them larger than 16 feet, 10 by 16 feet. Even though my actual studio space is small, you can make computer files that allow the file sizes to be very large and be printed with techniques used to print billboards or other large commercial techniques like that. But now I know enough about computers to farm out most of the actual computer work to other people and concentrate all my energies on doing the paintings and the drawings and working with the models, photographing them and videotaping them here in New York. And my interactive CD-ROM series is a basis of 12 series based on the Eastern zodiac. Each has an animal year. I've done the dragon year for the year 2000. I'm working on the snake year for the year 2001, and these paintings are going to be for the horse year. There's four canvases, one for each season, and a central painting for the sun. So it's going to be five canvases that make one large 9-foot oil on linen. And then they'll be scanned in the computer and combined with my photographs that I've taken of the models and underwater video and different videos of models dancing, all combined into an interactive CD-ROM, which also has files on the disc, where even if you don't have a computer, you could bring it to some place like Kinko's and have a print made, a color print, 11 by 17 inches print for your own home. And I have larger prints available. I've shown my work internationally. My digital work is currently available at Spectra Digital Gallery, which is on LaGuardia between Houston and Bleecker in New York. And they print work on demand, as well as having prints available in a number of sizes, and they also sell postcards of my work. I believe that painting and digital work are meant to be unified, though digital work is not going to supplant actual objects. I'm not in the camp where I think that they'll finally do away with paintings altogether, because there's nothing like having an actual handmade object that someone's created and put together. Though the impact of having digital prints being able to be infinite originals instead of a limited edition print is going to have a great impact on the art world, as well as creating wonderful opportunities and potential for artists, and also freeing them up from restricted studio sizes, whereas I've had studios smaller than this room where I've been able to create works that are, as I said, 16 feet and larger, just by using computer compositions together. So I think it's all very exciting and very compatible with each other. Thank you very much. As I was saying, I do at the same time as I do with the more realistic ones, with the extra palette paint that I have, and the palette knife. So I just do a little bit of this at a time. Thank you. is some more of my interpretation of God's creation of what would be Adam, but this is actually a woman. Same model posing twice, and one is speaking and one is listening, opposed to touching. This is sort of the beginning point of creation. The word. Anything all of that time. I'm going to show you what that is. Just all together. I'll do it. It's 16 feet long. It's the center section of the completed dress time piece. And, you can either hang it 16 any section now. Combination of my drawings, underwater photographs, and numbers. And this was intended to be about 20 by 30 inches. And then I did another version where I took this same thing. The thing about working with a computer is you can just keep laying on more stuff. If you look at this closely, you can see these figures here. These figures here are in the background of this image, which is a whole other image. And some of these digital prints are available at the Spectra Gallery. On LaGuardia between Bleecker and Houseman, where there, you can get these printed out on demand, called Print On Demand Pod. And images are available in any size you want. They even do canvas up to 7 feet or larger, and watercolor paper, and they also sell postcards, 50 cents of the work. That's one of the postcard images in the Spectra. Over 200 figures of it. Most all of them are ink wash drawings and paintings that I
done. So Each of the Four Seasons comes up a little bit distorted, depending on which season. This is spring, so it comes up sort of pointillist, like an impressionist painting. And then you click on one of the figures, and it comes into focus. So we saw one of this painting in my living room, 6 feet long. And the painting has 25 painted figures, and then approximately 25 photographs are added, and 3 or 4 videos. You click on something with 4 arrows, and you get the close-up from the figures. And if you push in some of the other areas, you get video function. This one is a professional hula dancer from Hawaii. She's doing a Tahitian dance now, actually. And you can scroll along and find other videos. A lot of them are underwater videos. I used to live in Los Angeles. I did a lot of videos of models swimming in pools underwater. In this video section, I had 2 models go to a one-man show I had in Santa Monica at Bergamont Station at Digitalog Gallery. They had actually modeled for some of the images they're standing in front of. They did a tour around the gallery. And then, you click here, go back to the main screen, and you can see a collection of all the stills in order. There's about 50 separate close-ups from the CD ROM. This is a mother with twin daughters. And this CD-ROM is also made with the Japanese market in mind, where you can't have any full frontal male nudity, so I took some of that out. Mm-hmm. And this is the image that's used on the cover of the CD.
Mm-hmm.
And the CD also has an instructional page on the inside, mm-hmm. telling you how to go from one section to the other.
Mm-hmm.
You can also go to see all four seasons side by side over here. Winter, spring, summer, and fall. Winter is all made up of single figures, and that's why there's one large single photographic figure that goes over the whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
Spring is mostly couples. Summer is groups of three, and fall is groups of four or more.
Mm-hmm.
And you can also go to the section and see all the videos side by side.
Mm-hmm.
There's about 15 videos. A lot of them are underwater. Sam hula dance is doing a hula dance now. She was doing a Tahitian dance last time. She's shot in my studio. There's actually a painting of her in the background. And I have some dancers as well. One of the dancers is a professional dancer. And Maria. And she's dancing here in front of one of my paintings while I'm stuck up. The CD-ROM also contains files to make prints, and we can take them, I can show you the prints where you can bring the disc to any Kinko's or print shop,
mm-hmm.
and they'll make 11 by 17 prints straight from the disc. That's pretty much that, so we can
okay.
that. Thank you. different things. In a minute I'll show you the thing on the canvas, but this is one of the last images that are a combination of my drawings, underwater photographs, and the numbers. And this was intended to be about 20 by 30 inches. And then I did another version where I took this same thing. The thing about working with a computer is you can just keep laying on more stuff. If you look at this closely, you can see these figures here. These figures here are in the background of this image, which is a whole other image. And some of these digital prints are available at the Spectra Gallery, as I said, on LaGuardia between Bleecker and Houseman, where there, you can get these printed out on demand, called Print On Demand, POD. And the images are available in any size you want. They even do canvas up to 7 feet or larger, and watercolor paper, and they also sell postcards, 50 cents of the work.
All right,
so we can go in the other room and I'll show you these larger prints again. That frame piece, square one in the middle, is print of this piece, Trust Time, partly inspired by the Sistine Chapel ceiling, though none of the figures are directly derived. The mostly made up, it's all my original material. I don't appropriate any other work from other artists or photos or anything like that. I take all the photos myself and do all the painting and all the drawing. This part here is mostly underwater photographs that I actually made a collage of and scanned in one piece, and then colorized a little bit with the computer, added some architectural details with these bars. The theme of the Sistine Chapel ceiling is called creation. It's also known as the fall of man, and I came up with the title Trust Time, T-R-U-S-T, which is another way of thinking about the, let me turn this around. No, don't sit there. What was that? Thinking about the fall of man is a fall into time from the steady state where nothing changes to the fall out of paradise is the fall into time, but also the fall is not a tragedy so much if you can trust time. This one is one of the last sections. It's very multi-layered. Move that piece down, rolled up. Another section. Some of this background imagery is from my palettes. acrylic palettes and paintings. Some of them is done directly on the computer. This is actually my little signature, which I showed you before, which is two knots come together. You probably can't see it very well in the dark. You can look again down and out. Includes this piece here, which is also shown in that lithograph detail up there I was telling you about.
Mm-hmm.
This is somewhat of my interpretation of God's creation of, or it would be Adam, but this is actually a woman. Same model posing twice, and one is speaking and one is listening. Opposed to touching. This is sort of the beginning point of creation. The word. You can roll those up. I'm going to show you this other detail. Just all together. I'll do it. It's 16 feet long. It's the center section of the completed Tristan piece. And you can either hang it 16 any section now.
Hello everyone, Exotica NY Show is signing off now. We thank you so much for the audience. Good night.